Over the last 4 years or so, my research group has been working with a material called graphene, which is a single atom thick sheet of carbon atoms linked to one another by covalent bonds. There's a lot of excitement about this material because this material has shown some extraordinary properties. For example, it is the strongest material in the world. It is the most conductive material in the world. It is the thinnest material in the world. And it is the most impermeable material in the world. So this material is only one atom thick, and yet it does not allow even the smallest molecules to pass through. My group has made some important contributions in the area of graphene-based biotechnologies and graphene-based quantum materials. So we were the first ones to make DNA sensors using graphene. And we also made bacterial sensors. And we also wrapped bacterial cells with graphenic sheets to make them impermeable. So now when you put these cells inside these electron microscopes, you can observe them in their original shape, original size, and morphology as they should be observed. The next phase of nanotechnology will be molecular machines. You could easily interface graphene with these molecular machines and either probe what is happening in these molecular machines or actuate these molecular machines. We are collaborating with the industry to fabricate large-scale graphene on silica substrates, which can then go into computers and other electronic devices. If you make a solution of graphene, you look at the solution, it is jet black, which means that it is absorbing a lot of light. Now, it will be really exciting if we can come up with a way to convert all this light which is being absorbed by this material into electricity to make solar cells, for example. A group of graduate students recently in our group developed the first graphene-based humidity sensor by just having these graphene quantum dots on this polymer. These guys built a humidity sensor, and we are in the process of publishing this right now.